morning. Members of the Board of Education of the Fulton City School District, Mr. David Cordone, President, Mr. Dan Hollowitz, Vice President, Mr. Tim Crandall, Clerk, Mrs. Brenda Abelhor, Mrs. Robin Griffin, Mrs. Lynn Lyons, and Mrs. Christine Platt. Also with us this morning on stage, Mr. Brian Polino, Superintendent of Schools, Mrs. Becky Connors, Executive Director of Instruction and Assessment, Mr. Mark Capati, Assistant Principal, Ms. Amy Stevenson, Assistant Principal, Fulton Mayor Ron Woodward, Mr. Robert Morse, Commencement Speaker, Madison Lane, Salutatorian, and Jacob Geithner. Share our day with our graduating seniors. Our seniors have invited Mr. Morse, chemistry teacher, to share this year's opening thoughts. Mr. Morse.
A new suit from Amazon.com, $99.99. The look of fear on Principal Parker's face when Jake and Maddie asked me to give the speech today, priceless. Thank you, Maddie and Jake, for that gift. I'm extremely honored to have the opportunity today to address the newest alumni of G.Ray Bodley High School. Please, do not view the brevity and pace of my address as anything other than my sincere respect I have for you and your time, and my belief that you should not address a large audience any longer than 10 minutes without the expectation of generating annoyance, as I have so unsuccessfully tried to convey to my supervisors for years. I'll not be so bold as to classify the following nine remarks as words of wisdom, for only your future and what you do with them can brand them as such. First, do not be sheep. The world does not need sheep. That is not to imply that teamwork is not essential, for it is. Rather, question what you are asked to do. Ask yourself, does it make sense? Is it reasonable? Is it logical? Is it fair? Is it coming from a trusted and reliable source, or is it coming from someone's personal agenda or lack of imagination? In a time where information is obtained and disseminated nearly instantaneously and often indiscriminately, you will need to ask yourselves these questions, lest be duped by those seeking to manipulate your understanding and beliefs. Second, failure is not a sign of weakness, and is not something you should be afraid of unless, as a result, you give up and learn nothing from it. Rather, failure is an opportunity to learn what path not to take, and sometimes, in that failure, we learn something that helps us in ways we could not possibly predict at the time. Do not be afraid to try new experiences, but do so without being reckless. Third, respect your uniqueness, but respect the uniqueness of others. Be tolerant of the beliefs, values, and skills of others in the way that you want society to be tolerant of you. That is not to suggest that you respect destructive and oppressive behaviors. As you learned in biology class, no species can survive without diversity. Take pride in your own skills, but appreciate the skills of others that you do not possess. Fourth, do not be mistaken in thinking that any of your teachers want you to become exactly like them. Rather, our goal is that you take a little piece of each of us, that particular piece that makes you a more valuable and productive member of society, and cement those pieces together with your own uniqueness. to be a person whom you, your family, and your future generations can be proud. Fifth, appreciate the sacrifices that millions have made to give us the standard of living we take for granted today. Those who've lost their lives and those who have labored willingly and unwillingly in the pursuit of a greater humanity. Sixth, do not ask more from others than you are willing to give yourself. Take pride in all the work you do, no matter how menial. Every job should be a work of art. Seven, many of you will become leaders, be it the leader of a few, or who knows, perhaps millions. A good leader does not surround themselves with friends and yes people, and that is because a good leader is competent and knowledgeable, but not all-knowing. A good leader, therefore, is not too arrogant to appreciate the dissenting advice of those around them and those who have earned their knowledge through hard work and diligence, and is wise enough to use that advice to alter the course to achieve the goal. Eighth, you do not have a fate. Each of us chooses our own destiny by deciding which path we will take. Do not expect great rewards if you are not willing to choose the uphill route. Expect hurdles, but be determined to overcome them. And do not let the ignorance of others discourage you from reaching your goals. Finally, aspire to create a society whose ideals are contagious. Endeavor to succeed in doing what my generation and other generations before mine could not do. Work for the day when the armies of brave men and women around the world do not fight against armies of other brave men and women, but rather fight with them, not to destroy and conquer, but to protect and build a greater society. Let me end by saying, our president has charged the people of the United States to make America great again. Without any political innuendos, I take that exception, exception to that charge, for it implies that America is no longer great. Despite many shameful chapters in our great country's history, slavery, racism, prejudices, to name a few, we became, and in my eyes still are, not only a great country, but the greatest country the world has ever known. For at no time in history has there been a country when so many people would choose to live, where so many people would choose to live if given the opportunity that we all take for granted. As previous generations have, you will face challenges that never before existed. It will only be by embracing and respecting the uniqueness of nearly every member of humanity that you will be able to overcome these challenges. So in conclusion, I charge you, class of 2018, with the daunting but rewarding task of making America greater. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Morris. It is now my pleasure to introduce our superintendent of schools, Mr. Brian Calvino, who would address our graduates.
Good morning, graduates of the class of 2018 and all in attendance to support them. Thank you for the privilege and honor of serving all of you, our families, and this community. Today is a special day. A day that will never be duplicated. A one-time event. This is your high school graduation. I want you to take a few seconds to savor this moment. You are surrounded by the people who believe in you, value you, and respect you, and are here to celebrate your hard work and accomplishments. I want you to take a moment and make a memory this morning, a special remembrance you will carry forever. And add a little bit to my speech here. Yesterday afternoon, and that's great that Mr. Morris talked about service to our country. About 3 weeks ago, we were contacted and a veteran had shared their story, a 94-year-old veteran. And he had been in attendance here in the Fulton City School District 78 years ago. And one of the things he shared was he never had a high school graduation remembrance. So yesterday, we did something that should have been done many decades ago, he served in his diploma in front of three generations of family. And as I looked into his eyes, it was one of the most special moments. Mr. Norman Smith became a graduate of the Fulton City School District yesterday. So please have a round of applause. It was absolutely amazing to look into his eyes and to watch his family take this moment. This moment is happening for you right now. You're in the moment. Each and every one of you know as you get older, you have more responsibilities each and every day. Greater responsibility requires you to make more choices and decisions on a daily basis. I was reading a blog called The Power of Choice by Najar. And they spoke about the average working adult makes about 12 decisions before 9 o'clock in the morning. Obviously, this number varies on an individual basis, but a study by Cornell University states that an adult makes about 70 plus choices a day. Once one opens his or her eyes, the first decisions made are to snooze or not to snooze. I know none of you men are to snooze, right? What side of the bed to roll out of? What will I wear today? Maybe will I go to work? I know that answer will always be yes, and go to class is yes. Some decisions have short-term effects, and others with long-term outcomes. Should I stay in this job, this relationship, this area of the country? There will always be days when you don't want to make decisions or choices. There will be moments where it may seem easier to let someone else make the choice. However, remember, you have the power of choice to make decisions that will shape your life's story. There will be times when you will have to make tough decisions to address complex situations and other people may challenge you. There will be other times when the choice is clear and it is smooth sailing on your journey. Make sure the choices and decisions you make keep you on the path to your dreams. There are three things that will help you make those decisions and those choices. Prepare yourself for the choice you must make. Clearly understand the situation or the problem. Make sure you ask questions and you have as much information as possible to make an informed choice. Work closely with others who may have the knowledge and the experience and draw from them. Second, evaluate the outcome. If I choose to do this, then what's going to happen? Very simple. Follow through the decision, go for it, and move forward on to the next choice or decision. So prepare, evaluate, and follow through. The power of the choice is truly yours. It's yours. Doesn't cost anything. It's from here. And all of the experiences you've had with your families, throughout the schooling experience here in the Fulton City School District, all of that will help you lead to the next choices that you must make. So many of our dreams at first seem impossible, then they seem improbable, and then when we summon the will, they become inevitable. That's Christopher Reeve, portrayed Superman. Make the choices that will allow you to pursue and achieve your hopes and dreams. Make every day a great day. The choice is truly yours. Stay the course as you shape your life's journey. Be the change in the world that you want to happen. We're very proud of the accomplishments of the class of 2018. Congratulations, graduates and their families. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Salvino. It is now time to hear from our students. It has been refreshing to watch a natural, quiet leader learn and grow in her studies, be self-motivated, take initiative, and always maintain a positive demeanor. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Madison Lane, salutatorian of the class of 2018.
Morning, everyone. What's up? Thank you, Mrs. Parker, legendary Mr. Morse, staff, faculty, parents, and of course, you guys, the class of 2018. It's an honor to speak in front of so many people, and honestly, it's pretty intimidating too. So I'll try my best to hold my breath this time, not choke. So first and foremost, I want to thank the people who made today possible and shaped me as the young lady I have become. I would like to thank my incredible parents, Mary and Terry, because without you, I don't know where I'd be. Seriously, if you had adopted me 17 years ago, I could have been it up anyway. How's it going in China, working in the right schools? I said this to your daughter, and I'm so incredibly grateful to have you as my number one supporter in school and in London. On behalf of the senior class, I extend a thanks to all parents and family members who have helped us along the way. Next, I'd like to thank all my teachers and coaches. You dedicated yourselves to helping us learn, and you deserve more credit than you often get. You teach us every day, and you put up with our complaining and other daily bullshit. Thank you for making learning fun and encouraging us to challenge ourselves. And of course, I would not be here without my awesome group of friends and the class of 2018. 4 years ago, we came through the doors of G.Ray Bodley for the first time at States, ready to take on high school. As the years passed, both of our classes got each other, and our wealth lived regularly upon. But hey, we made it. Despite what others say, the class of 2018 will forever be one of the most legendary group of kids that have helped us all together. I'd also like to give a shout out to big man number one, Jake Geithner. Congrats on being the try-hardest of the try-hardest. I wouldn't have wanted to share the podium today with anyone else. Okay. So, while writing the speech last night, I came across the website for writing a semi-decent graduation speech, and according to them, I'm supposed to give some friendly advice to my fellow classmates. I don't want to sound cliche and play the typical work hard, be happy, eat your vegetables type of advice, because we've all heard that plenty of times throughout the years. However, I'm in no position to give other kids my age advice on how to live life or what they need to be successful. Because honestly, I'm just as concerned about what I'm doing with my life as you probably are. So, here are some words of wisdom from people more qualified to give them than me. Steve Jobs once said, your time is limited, so don't waste living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions run out of your own. You have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. You have the power to impact the lives of others and maybe even change the world. So be yourself and take a stand for what you believe in. Being true to yourself is key for facing the unknown of life. But even then, I refer to my AP cousins, which are Mrs. Ryan, who always reminded us to keep an open mind because we're going to meet so many new people from diverse backgrounds. While it may seem easy to judge someone by their looks or by the way they act, keep in mind that there are hundreds of other cultures and ethnicities distinct from what we're used to here in Texas. This is where I stress the idea that we must learn to respect and embrace all different types of cultures. So learn someone else's story before you pass judgment. Well, everyone, it's been a fun ride. I'll always share the last we shared, the lessons we learned, and the memories made. Now go out with that success making, make even more memories. I look forward to hearing some crazy stories that are testing me in contenders. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Manny. As you said in your words, when I wrote my speech last night, the looks on some of your faces, she wrote that last night. And yes, Madison, Ms. Florio, saw you on Google Docs at 1:15 this morning. Another leader among our student body and community, full of insights, an athlete, scholar, and extremely passionate about life and learning. I say to him, stand proud and revel in this well-deserved accomplishment. I am now honored to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2018, Jacob Geithner.
Good morning, class of 2018, G.Ray Bodley staff, family, and friends. The speech I prepared for you today is going to be very similar to GRB just showed by the next year. Long enough to cover the subject, but short enough to be interested. On a real note, congratulations to all of us for making it through these past 4 years. Although some may view high school graduation as an effortless accomplishment, we all know how difficult academics can be. And we also faced behind-the-scenes challenges that made our individual paths towards this day a little bit more complicated. Overcoming these obstacles made today all the more worthwhile. I think we would all agree that today would not be a reality without a strong support system. Whether it is a family member or a friend, we all have someone that we can thank for helping us reach this day. Personally, I would like to thank my family for all they have done for me, specifically my parents for being the best role models I could ever ask for, my sister for always bringing a voice to experience this situation, my grandparents for being my biggest fans, and my aunts and uncles for doing everything that everyone else forgot. A special thank you to all the friends I made throughout my time here. I would have never had the chance to deliver this speech without Sarah or Maddie, who constantly elevated to my best and have taught me kindness and compassion. As for Nick, Jeremy, Nolan, and all my baseball guys, I would probably be on the stage today without you all, but I certainly would not have had fun afterwards. While I could also thank you and every teacher I've ever had, you don't want to repeat a blast, so I'm going to name three of the most influential, all of which I was lucky enough to have my freshman year and then again later on. Ms. Gloria, Mrs. Dawson, and Mr. Mainville. As freshmen, you taught the true purpose of learning and broadened our perspective of the world. Thank you, and I expect all of you to follow me back on Facebook after today's session. Now, with the thank yous out of the way, I would like to serve with some wisdom. Unfortunately, when I was writing this speech, I felt a lot of pressure to achieve the perfect balance between profound and lighthearted. Instead of trying to write this on my own, I called upon some influential figures for their famous words of wisdom. The first comes from my favorite president, Barack Obama. In the congressional delivery that brought the American public universal health care, he stated, "We did not come here to view the future, we came here to shape it." As we move into the next stage of our life, there are a variety of reasons why these words are true. There were things that we did not learn during our time at GRB, so the future holds many uncertainties. Rather than approaching these obstacles with caution, we should welcome experiences with strength and confidence. As new challenges are tackled, don't allow your shortcomings to define you, but rather use them to create a better version of yourself. In his aptly named second album, Graduation, Kanye West captures this concept by claiming, "Everything I'm not made me everything I am." Clear up this intensive poetic verse and bridge the generational gap for our older audience members. Kanye is simply saying that we will never be able to live up to people's expectations due to its flaws. These imperfections serve to mark the truth of reality. Lastly, poet Dylan Thomas, and also Matthew Kanye, once said, "Do not go gentle into that good night. Rage, rage into the dying of the light." As we all try to find our place in this extremely overpopulated world, we are going to experience failures. So rather than grieving over these obstacles, learn from them. In life, similarly to the boys across the end of season, you will only have one or two shots of success. So no matter what you do, live every day with unforgivable passion and unfading persistence. Moving forward, I hope you are all able to combine the principles of these three quotes. Upon each and every one of you, I wish a perfect balance of Obama's eloquence, Kanye's confidence, and Thomas's fearlessness. Best of luck to the underclassmen of G.Ray Bodley. You guys have a lot to live up to, except you only have 8 bells to do it. To see my speech again, follow me on Twitter at JJunior, or just type the graduation speeches into Spark Notes and read through the third one down. Congratulations, class of 2018. Made it by forever.
Thank you, Jacob. Mr. Cordone, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of G.Ray Bodley High School, and with great pride, I present to you the graduating class of 2018, and I ask that you address this year's graduates, Mr. Cordone.
Good morning. On behalf of the Board of Education, I welcome all of you to today's commencement ceremony as we celebrate the accomplishments of the soon-to-be graduates before us, the class of 2008. I offer a special thank you to all of the dignitaries on this stage for their presence on this special occasion. For our graduates, this day represents a new beginning. As each of you are graduates, pause and reflect on your educational experience provided to you in the Fulton City School District. To celebrate your accomplishments and successes to this point in your lives, today's ceremony marks the beginning of life's next phase. Whether you are planning to attend an institution of higher learning, a vocational or trade school, to join the workforce, or perhaps the armed services. Today is truly a day of celebration for you, as it is for all of the people who have supported you along the way. Today, you have heard a number of inspirational quotes that hold special meaning to those of us before you who have the honor of sharing them with you. And here are a few of mine. Education is our passport to the future, where tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today. A quote by Malcolm X. It is the role of the Board of Education to make the decisions that have provided you this passport in the Fulton City School District. And your presence here today is evidence that we have effectively served in our role, and it is a day of celebration that all school board members treasure. Another favorite quote of mine, in any moment of decision, the best thing you can do is the right thing. The next best thing is the wrong thing. And the worst thing you can do is nothing. As you approach your future, remember to always take decisive action given the best information you have. Be intentionally active and take a leadership role in your community wherever you reside. You can and will make a difference, and you should. A quote by Joy Bell, you may not know where you're going, but so long as you spread your wings, the winds will carry you. This quote reminds me that we are each destined for success if we have a vision and a plan for our future. So define your own vision and know what you value most in life. And on the lighter side, a quote by G.Ray Bodley, your families are extremely proud of you. You can't imagine the sense of relief they are experiencing. This would be a most opportune time to ask for money. That one speaks for itself. And finally, a quote by Benjamin Franklin. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Today marks the beginning of your life's journey as a high school graduate. In the next few minutes, know that your parents, who remember the very first steps you took as a toddler, your principals, who remember the first steps you took in the school building you attended, and your teachers, who remember the first steps you took in each of their classrooms, are with you as you cross this stage and take the first step in life's 1,000-mile journey that awaits you. They are all with you then, as they are with you now. And on behalf of the Board of Education, it is my privilege to congratulate each of you as you mark the beginning of your first high school. Congratulations to our graduates, the class of 2018, their parents, and the staff of the
Thank you, Mr. Forgot. Before we continue with the next part of our ceremony, I have a few announcements to make. Today's ceremony is being recorded and will be shown on local cable channel 96 on the date listed in the commencement program. So please check that program for that information. Also, a professional photographer is here today to take photos of each student as they receive their diplomas. Parents, you will receive proof and order forms over the summer, early summer. And finally, we do kindly ask that you refrain from gathering around our stage in order for everyone present to be able to see and honor our graduates. Many of our graduates will be receiving awards and scholarships today, and many of them are unaware of these honors. This will be the first time some of them will hear they have won a particular award. Check with the mail next week with diplomas. Graduates, families, staff members, and I are very proud of these accomplishments. And I take this opportunity to commend you, graduates, for striving toward success. With that in mind, and in an effort to keep our ceremony moving, as it is, I respectfully ask that you hold your applause until the very last graduate has received their diploma. Let's recognize some of their hard-earned, well-earned accomplishments.
Would any student who participated in an advanced placement course please stand? I need to ask them all, in case you keep breathing smile. Next, would any student who enrolled in our New Vision program please stand proud? New Vision students. In a CTE course through City Bosie. Please stand. Next, any student who participated in a
Mrs. Parker, Mr. Gordon, presenting the class of 2018. Your first graduate, Marissa Allen, SUNY Oswego. Gabrielle Bailey, SUNY Ohio. Gabrielle is a recipient of the Oswego Teachers Employee Federal Credit Union Award and the Rita C. Rowland Memorial Award. Justin Martin, SUNY ESS. Addison Billion, University at Buffalo. Addison is a recipient of the Historic Gaylord Trust Scholarship and New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence Award. Matthew Boro, SUNY Oswego. Matthew is a recipient of the Dave Lennon Scholarship. Kevin Boyd, Rochester Institute of Technology. Lillian Bray, SUNY Delhi. Lillian is the recipient of the Fulton City Excellence in Accounting Award, the Ellen Johnson Memorial Award, and Women's Club of Fulton Scholars. Jade Bryant, Hofstra University. Jade is the recipient of the Joe Kusick Memorial Fellowship, Fulton Elks Lodge 830, and the Oswego County Counselors Association Award. Elizabeth Brown, SUNY Geneseo. Lauren Burke, Hewitt Community College, is the recipient of the FBLA Raiders Grand Business Scholarship, the Fulton Savings Bank Excellence in Accounting Award, and the Oswego County Educational Secretary Scholarship Award. Hannah Burleigh, Duquesne University. Haley Carroll, University at Albany.